All together now.
What can make me feel this way, my girl, my
Motown Fridays on the Jerry Agar Show on In-Depth Radio, News Talk 1010. I am told that in Ontario we got some mighty fine wine. However, apparently not so easy to find. It's not necessarily the case that you can just decide to drive from anywhere at all in Ontario to Niagara and pick up a wine you've heard about. If it's not immediately available, then oftentimes it isn't purchased, except maybe by the most aggressive wine fanatics. And I'm not one of those. I'm not a big wine drinker, so I'm, but hey, I know a lot of people are. I'm more, you know, beer and Jack Daniels kind of guy. And rum, I love Bacardi 8. But I know a lot of people appreciate wine and would appreciate the fact that the fine wines are made in Ontario. Joining me now, Michael Pinkus. He's the president of the Wine Writers Circle of Canada, does OntarioWineReview.com. Michael, welcome.
Hi, Jerry. How are you?
I'm doing well. So am I right, first of all, and I hope you're not just sort of being an Ontario booster, do we really have great wine in Ontario?
Yes, we actually do have great wine in Ontario. We really had bad stuff back in the 60s, the 70s, moving maybe into the 80s. We started to do some really good stuff, and now it's just getting better and better and better. And I'm not just an Ontario wine booster because I taste wines from all over the world. In fact, right at this moment, I'm sitting, I shouldn't say this really, but I'm in the LCBO, and I'm doing a tasting for the vintages that's coming up in 6 weeks. So I do taste a lot of wine from all over the world.
All right. And I would expect, Michael, when you get into the business that you're in, it's all about the wine, and you want to talk about wine, you want to drink wine, you want to write about wine, and you don't want to get into politics. But you've been getting into politics on your blog.
Well, when I originally started this about 10 years ago, I said to my web designer, I said, no way we're going to get into politics. It's all about the wine, and you were right about that. But it just seems if you're selling wine in Ontario, it is about politics. It's not about just getting out there and selling wine. And I know you used to live in the States, and it's a lot easier to get stuff down there. I'm going to Florida at the end of January, and I'm looking forward to that because I can buy some, you know, so many different kinds of wine down there. And I also get a lot of local wine, not just Florida, but I mean, you know, throughout the United States. And here in Canada, you know, in Ontario especially, we just don't have that access to the wine, you know, our own wine from BC and especially from Ontario. There are so many wineries making so many good wines, and yet, you know, not all Ontarians can put their hands on it.
No, in a market like they have in the United States, if you're a vintner and you want to sell your wine and Jim's Liquors won't carry it, then Bob's Liquors will carry it. Here, if the LCBO doesn't carry it, what do you do?
You cry.
Yeah, exactly. So they're talking about maybe having wine available at farmers markets, but then there are goofy restrictions on that. Like they can't serve any wine before 11 in the morning, and by that time, the farmers market is starting to wind down.
Exactly, and you can't store any alcohol off-site. So if you have a winery, you can't store your wine off-site. So that means every day you have to drive a truck or your car to the farmer's market, and then when you're done, you're done. If you wanted, if you only brought 10 cases along and you sell all 10 cases, then that's it. You can't sell any more.
Well, you know, where I used to live, which was in the neighborhood of the Rogers Center, there's a Sobeys down there, and you walk in and there's a little wine operation on the one side that you can go into, wine rack, I guess, and then, you know, it has some wine, but it's not a very big place. Do they have the Ontario wines?
They do, but here's the thing about crazy Ontario wine laws is that the wine rack, and I believe it's the wine shop, are run by two companies, and that's it, and that's Peller and basically Vincor, which is Jackson Triggs and Esquilin. And those are the only two companies that are allowed to have these stores because they were grandfathered in after free trade when it said you cannot open any more stores off-site.
So now
we're stuck.
Yeah.
I think there's 263, 250 licenses that are off-site licenses, and they're held by basically two companies.
Well, it's very much like the beer store then. I'm talking to Michael Pinkus. He's president of the Wine Writers Circle of Canada. How do these people who make wine in Canada, who have gathered the expertise, put in the hard work to make a really great wine, how do they make money off of it then?
Do you know what? I tip my hat every day to the winemakers of, well, especially Ontario, BC. In BC, they love their wine, and they sell their wine, you know, and they have what they call VQA wine stores. which are stores that, that you can walk into and you can taste and buy strictly BC VQA wines. That would be a great idea here. Why not take some of those 263 licenses that are owned by Peller or especially Vincor? Vincor has turned into Constellation. Constellation is actually an American company. Peller, I say leave them alone. They are a Canadian company. They can have their stores. But Vincor was bought by Constellation, which is a company out of New York. Why do they still have access to these stores?
You're listening to Jerry Agar on In-Depth Radio, News Talk 1010.
A bottle of white, a bottle of red.
Whichever you produce in Ontario, you've got marketing issues because we have such draconian laws on the distribution and sale of alcoholic products in the province. I've talked about this before, more specifically just because I dislike the monopoly of the LCBO, but specifically from the perspective of Ontario wineries trying to sell their wine to Ontarians. We're talking about the difficulties with Michael Pinkus, president of the Wine Writers Circle of Canada and OntarioWineReview.com. You know, I asked you a moment ago, Michael, how these wine operators, these vintners, make money with all of the difficulties. And somebody sent me a text message saying that he heard from a person who was in the business that they are subsidized by the government.
There's a thing in this, what they call growing new opportunities for Ontario wines, where the government is now going to put in $75 million into the wine industry. You know, it's a little late. They should have been doing this, you know, years ago. But it's also just on the coming on the, and I know you love this topic, it's coming on the heels of basically buying an election in Niagara. Who are we kidding?
Yeah, there's going to be a by-election in Niagara, and the Liberals have $75 million for the wine industry. I think that's a coincidence, Michael.
A huge coincidence.
Yeah, well,
I think we've heard this before. I think it was somewhere in Etobicoke in Mississauga, but I'm not 100% sure.
I think it was Oakville in Mississauga.
Oh, there actually. We go. Yes, thank you.
Yes. Okay, so, but here's the deal. Rather than have to come up with some kind of government program to subsidize the vintners, let the vintners loose to sell their product, and if they make it, they make it. God bless them. And if they don't, well, that's how business works.
Well, exactly. That's how the free market should work. And, you know, if we gave them the opportunity to open up wine stores where they wanted to, that would be great. Now this government has said, okay, well, we're gonna help them. We're gonna open up these Ontario VQA boutiques in selected stores. So if you were the LCBO and you were going to be opening up a VQA boutique, where would you open them up, Jerry?
First of all, what's a VQA?
Oh, VQA is Vintners Quality Alliance.
Oh.
That's 100% Ontario grapes.
Oh, I see.
100% Ontario wine.
All right. I don't know where I would put it because I'm not in the business. That's why I say that's how private business with as little interference as possible from the government works. They figure it out.
Well, the LCBO put their very first three boutiques, which carry more VQA wine, they put them in Niagara Falls, St. Catharines, and Windsor.
So it's the easiest places to get to the wine in the first place.
Exactly. And another one's going into Belleville, which is only 20 minutes away from Prince Edward County, which, again, makes wine. Why you wouldn't put them in places like Toronto, Kingston, Ottawa, London, major centers, Sudbury, Timmins, these places don't have access to wine. Putting them in St. Catharines, I can drive to a winery in St. Catharines in 20 minutes. Why am I going to go to an LCBO store and go to that boutique? I think the obvious reason is it's to stymie the wineries, to, you know, take money away from them.
Yeah. Well, I think it says a lot when a guy who some years ago got into the business that you are in to talk about and promote and enthuse about wine specifically said, I'm not getting into politics, and you've been forced into politics. And it's simply because the politics is hurting the business. And if what they want to do is use $75 million to pretend they're helping the business, but really in order to just win another seat, we have yet another cynical, outrageous piece of activity from the Liberal government.
I have to agree with you there, Jerry. I want to believe that they want to help, But, you know, there are so many other ways that they could help. They could let them open stores. They could open VQA-only stores. When they did this out in British Columbia, the British Columbian government said, well, we're not allowed to open new stores or offsite. But suddenly they found some new licenses. You know what I mean? They just kind of found them.
Yeah.
Why can't Ontario just find a few licenses that come up before 1993?
Thanks for your time.
No problem. Thank you, Jerry.
Michael Pinkus, president of the Wine Writers Circle of Canada.